Shotgun with Charlie.
Riding shotgun refers to the practice of sitting next to the driver in a moving vehicle. The term riding shotgun came around after the time of the stagecoach, when somebody used to sit next to the driver holding a shotgun, in case they ran into bandits. My name is Charlie Cook, and I drive a lot. I like to talk to people while I'm driving, so I interview people in my car while I'm driving. Welcome to Riding Shotgun with Charlie. All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to this episode of Riding Shotgun with Charlie. Before we get to our guest for today, I do want to say that we are still in sunny Florida, and I'm wearing my pants on, gun on shirt, carry every day, thanks to Gary Doherty and the guys at the Polite Society podcast, Paul Lathrop, Rob Morris, John Richardson, and their other guests and co-hosts and cohorts. I know they have these shirts. Pants on, gun on. We call it pogo here in the biz. Anyway, today our guest is none other than Kevin Sona from Florida Carry. Kevin
Sona. What's going on, Charlie?
Living the dream, brother. We do have KJ in the back. Kevin Jr.
Stick your head out. Stick your head through.
Say hey.
Hi.
No, hey.
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 There you go.
Hey. All right.
That worked.
Okay, let's go for a drive. We're here in sunny Florida. We got a full tank of gas, a half a pack of cigarettes. It's 102 miles to the Gators, and
102 miles to the Gators. Yeah. We're gonna go check out some
like
Gators.
The Blues Brothers, man.
You're gonna hang a right.
All right. Okay, so we're here. We've just spent the weekend at this awesome. Speaking of the Blues Brothers, we're gonna.
They're right there.
They are right there. Well, how do we?
We'll have to get a picture of that. I'm way back.
Oh, as long as we come this way. Yeah. All right. Yep. We just spent an awesome weekend with you. An event that you organized as yep. part of the Florida Carry Region 5 meet and greet Q&A with a number of awesome speakers.
Absolutely.
And me. So we're going to...
Well, you were, you know.
Oh, yeah, I know, right.
I was had to. Absolutely. Right.
You know, we slide one in, one good bunch, or one bad speaker doesn't totally ruin the bunch, but it's not so bad.
We did okay.
We did all right. Let's talk.
I think I was the most nervous.
You were the most
nervous? Way out of my wheelhouse.
But here's the scoop. All right, so I've been telling you this for a long time. You really need to bunk up and work on your speaking skills.
Yep.
You've got great organizational skills in putting all these events together, and you put events together on a pretty regular basis for Florida Carry.
We do.
Whether it's the fishing events, the open carry rallies. We're going to talk about all that stuff.
Cool beans. It's not just me. It's all our other region leads as well. And all 11 other regions.
All 11 so. Regions in Florida. It's a big state down here.
It's a big state. And we're trying to... I'm personally trying to hit every event in at least one region throughout the state of Florida. So.
That's awesome. That's awesome. All right. Tell us quick history, your story into becoming a gun guy, or how you, did you grow up hunting or shooting?
I did. I grew up in the South. South Jersey.
South Jersey.
So, grew up in South Jersey in a little
town. Hey, South Jersey.
How you doing? A little town, Little Lake Harbor, New Jersey, Ocean County, southern part of Ocean County.
Yeah.
Grew up hunting and fishing in a fishing community. Grew up
cool.
the whole my entire life. Didn't realize how bad the whole gun scene was with gun laws until I really moved to Florida to an almost free state. Not quite the gunshine state yet, but we're trying.
Right?
We are definitely trying. But no, that's when I got involved in gun rights, really moving down here. I realized how bad we had it in Jersey.
Yeah.
And I'm still trying to help my friends and family that are still in the Republic of New Jersey.
Republic of New Jersey. Occupied territory is what I call it.
You got that
like
right.
That. And yeah, I live in occupied territory too, so.
I'm a little upset with you, actually.
Oh, boy. What did I do this time?
You go to Jersey all the time?
I go to Jersey, yes.
And who do you visit Jersey?
I usually visit, I stop by the Gun for Hire Agency, Anthony Calandro.
Okay. And never once in Jersey have you had a pork roll, egg, and cheese. So basically, you had to come all the way down to Florida to get a pork roll and cheese, which is not quite the same here because the bread.
You cook.
The bread's not bread's not as good. The rolls aren't as good.
Aren't as good.
No, the eggs were okay, but the
What the hell are these things we just drove by? Cranes?
They were giant cranes.
Oh my gosh!
And not construction cranes.
Wildlife.
They
were here, man.
Oh, you'll see a ton of cattle and. And you know, like I told you when you came down here, you gotta watch out for
bears, deer, bear, and boar. I figured this out. It's all animals that you don't put an S to make a plural.
it really is.
I know. Did you plan that?
There are geese too. So you're not
geese's.
You're not worried about geese's.
Do the Canada geese fly all the way down here?
Canada geese come here a lot.
They go south for the winter. They're a snowbird.
Absolutely.
There we go.
So we're gonna go check out some gators at the.
We're gonna check out real gators.
You gotta see gators. You're in Florida.
I'm in Florida, right? You know, bear and boar and gators. Oh my.
I'm looking forward to seeing you wrestle one.
Great. Yeah, that'll be an episode. All of a sudden, writing Shotgun with Charlie's canceled.
No.
The host has died in a gator accident.
Not only the mean mommies will be mad at you because you're
the gator moms.
You know, basically a firearms rights, civil rights channel, you're gonna have PETA after you now.
Great. Yeah.
But I'm a member.
People eating tasty animals.
Yeah, there you go. You have to be a member of that PETA. That's the good PETA.
Cool. All right. So you found out that the after you moved to Florida, you found out the gun laws in Jersey, and that's when you became active. You've been a hunter and a shooter for quite some time.
My whole life, my whole family. Yeah.
Very cool. Very cool. What did you like to shoot?
Jersey was basically like shotgun. I grew up with shotguns. I'm a shotgun guy. Straight on through, followed around.
Straight on through, follow the gator signs.
Yep, follow the gator signs. Watch for gators.
Do they have gator crossing?
They do. Alligator Alley, a lot of roads.
This is real.
Yep. On Tamiami, which you laughed at.
Tamiami Trail.
Especially if you go further south.
All right, let's stay focused. So, you're a shotgun guy. You moved from Jersey to Florida.
Mm-hmm.
How long did you start becoming more active with the Florida Carry?
I think I hooked up with Florida Carry probably around 2013. We're dealing with them on Facebook and talking with Richard Naskak, our executive director, and Sean Carana, the other executive director, and getting involved. And then 2015, I guess it was, Tampa. We went to GRPC.
2016.
Yeah, Gun Rights Policy Conference, Second Amendment Society.
Yeah, that was great. That was where we met.
That's where we met. That's where I met a lot of gun folks.
A lot of really cool people. Yeah, I see the road turns.
Yeah, it's a little sharp.
That's all right. It's a Hemi.
Hemis don't help you stop or turn.
Well, that's what the brakes are for.
No, do you want to help turn a little throttle?
All right. All of a sudden, you're Lightning McQueen here.
We'll see.
Right. Gators. So, Gun Rights Policy Conference, Tampa, Florida, 2016. You met a ton of people. That's the first GRPC that I went to, and it really opened up to see that there are so many more people than I ever realized that are out here fighting for our rights and being active and speaking at events and having podcasts. And to me, it was just one of these things that, that'd be cool if you can get this going. And Riding Shotgun was in its prenatal era.
Yep,
then
yep.
I was it was something I was working on and didn't put any shows out and didn't do anything.
Yep.
And it was great to meet so many people, and you got to meet a ton of people there, and that's where you took off.
I got to meet a ton of people there, and that's kind of where I started meeting the Florida Carry guys in person. And we went from there, and it was at that meeting that Steve Moret, our board member who's in charge of member affairs, him and I kind of started talking. Actually, on Sunday when we were leaving the parking lot for an extra hour, ended up speaking and talking about... creating regions in the state of Florida, but basically dividing the state up so we can better serve our Florida Carry members. And it just started snowballing and working from there. And I've kind of, as Steve says, kind of his right-hand man.
That's cool. That's awesome.
And that's grown to something else. And, What happened this time? I ended up somehow being asked to join Florida Carry as a sitting board member.
That's awesome. Congratulations.
I am really, really fired up about that. more than that, I'm fired up that Florida Carrier went above and beyond, and they gave Sarah a plaque.
They gave my wife an award. Yeah. It's not just for dealing with you, but it's
mostly for dealing with me. But yeah,
I will tell you this. I've been camping for the last couple days, hanging out at your house. She works her tail off.
Yeah,
she works really hard.
She does. She kicks butt. That's for sure. She's been my unsung little, I don't know if it's a little, but she's been my unofficial co-lead in Region 5, and helping me organize and do things, and so she's been hands on with everything and just doesn't get the recognition, and I'm excited that she does. And
yeah,
it actually almost made me cry watching her up there, because it was really cool.
It was cool.
And then, we had Dennis Fields, who got our Region 4 lead, who got an award for his dedication to Florida Carry and
awesome
and things he's doing, and Stephen Jenkins, good buddy of mine, who we are creating a video podcast together.
Yeah, we're going to hit that too.
Yeah,
we're
going to
hit
that too. Perfect.
So what kind of things have you done in the past with your Florida Carry folk?
What have things we've done in the past? Other events?
Yeah, some other events that you've done.
I organized the first open carry event with long guns in the state of Florida. For Florida Carry. For Florida Carry.
Wow.
So that was interesting.
As a non open carry guy, to open carry a rifle or shotgun? Holy moly, man.
How'd you like it today? This weekend, you open carry?
I did open carry. It's just a little weird for me. I guess it becomes more normal. I still checked my hip to make sure the gun was there. It wasn't too bad. I was in a safe area with everyone else that was packing.
Okay.
But it's just...
Were you you got comfortable with it?
Yeah,
you didn't realize you were open carry.
Yes, you just like carrying concealed, you get a good holster that fits well, and you eventually forget that you're... No, I don't say forget that you're carrying.
Yeah, you're always aware.
Right, you are always aware, but you realize it's really not that bad.
What's the difference in your shirt cover? Thin little layer of fabric.
I thought you said fat, Greg.
No.
What
fabric.
Are you trying to say?
Thin layer of fabric.
Thin layer of fabric, right. Yeah, that's it. So I'm carrying now, I got my pants on, gun on shirt, and since we are no longer camping, I cannot carry openly because we are not camping or concealed. We are not camping, we are not hiking, and we are not fishing.
Hiking's not part of it.
What is it?
Hiking's not part of it.
What are the three things?
Hunting, fishing.
That's what it was.
Target shooting, camping, and going to and from during those events.
Aren't we going to hunt alligators?
We will hunt alligators.
Today, because we're on our way. If we're on our way to hunt alligators,
we could. I have a pretty. I got a neat idea, actually.
Oh boy, I don't know about it. I don't know if I like these ideas.
No, your
idea brought me down here for the weekend.
I think the next spot that you have an opening, I think you need to pull over for a moment. As soon as you find a nice spot that's open here, maybe.
All right,
maybe just road right
up here.
I think the road.
Or are we gonna pull on the side?
There's a side road here on the left, I believe.
Just pull over.
I have an idea.
We're just gonna pull over. Is this a side road?
This is really the shoulder. You could have pulled over there. That road to the left.
All of a sudden, I feel like the Duke
instead of going off road.
This looks like an official place.
We're good. Little league park. Hang a left in here. This would work perfect.
Little league park.
Bike path. Pull up right over here. I go up by the thing up here.
Up by the thing.
I can show you something really cool if you want. Go right straight up through here. Right straight up and around here.
I see Barney the dinosaur at the playground.
This is pretty neat. This is the spillway, the English spillway in Levy County.
The English spillway. Tell me about the English spillway.
It's just a spillway. Actually, we have the English lock that's not far from right up the road here. The lock is where I guess it was in the 60s. That they were going to cut through the state of Florida from the Gulf of Mexico to the Atlantic. Drive right up here.
Just keep going?
Yeah, drive right here.
All right. I have no idea what you're going in for, man.
It's pretty cool area.
This little body of water is the...
This is all fresh water here, the stream over here to the left, river over here to the left, and it will definitely... There's a lot of big gators in there.
A lot.
I fish here all the time.
For gators?
Yeah. with for gators, for bass, for largemouth bass.
Very cool.
It's I actually pull it right here. This would be cool.
Right here?
Go up here at the opening, right here.
Alright.
You can pull over here in the grass a little bit.
Alright, we're gonna pull over. I have no idea what you're gonna do, man. I'm a little freaked out.
Just watch the rocks.
Sam, still pull off the road.
You wanna sit here? Go down there. It's a weird angle.
No.
Pull over a little more.
Pull over a little more.
A little more, you know, where you're level.
This is not a four-wheel drive, dude.
No, well, you just off-road now. Perfect, right here. You're good to go.
All right, we're going to go look at some gators?
Not yet.
Not yet?
Not yet.
Oh, all right.
I want to show you something, though. Jump out real quick.
All right, we're going to hop out. We'll be right back.
Jump out.
Uno momento, por favor. Seasick.
Why?
Because you're driving.
See, now look, there were speed bumps up here.
Yeah.
Now you were just ramming over them.
I wasn't ramming over them. I know.
See,
this
look. I'm gonna brake. Look,
go.
Who's taking care of the rental car better? You or me?
Right. Yeah. Hey, no laughing back there. Alright. So I better see some gators out of this deal, man.
You'll see some gators, I promise you.
Alright.
That's a speed bump, by the way.
I see the speed bump. Not like I'm blind, man. All right, so you got Florida carry going on.
Mm-hmm.
You've got your events. You did the first open carry long gun event.
Open carry long gun. That was last year, April 9th of last year. Well, I'll tell you what. I was hoping for 100 people show up, and we didn't hit that.
Oh, no.
No.
That's not good.
No, it wasn't bad.
How many people did you get?
268.
Whoa!
So, we are aiming again now. We are doing another one in 2 months, I guess.
Holy
April 6th this time, which happens to be a Florida... Check this out, Charlie. Happens to be a Florida freshwater free fishing weekend. So, no one needs...
That's cool.
No one needs a freshwater... So, no one needs to go spend $17.50 for a fishing license. You can do it for free. And while you're engaged in fishing...
Yeah.
You can open carry or conceal carry.
There we go.
A long gun. I mean, a handgun. Or you can open... carry a
handgun.
You can open or conceal handguns, or you can open carry a long gun.
That's pretty wild.
See, it's all rocky here, so I'm taking
it's
my
all
time.
Rocky. I appreciate that.
Let's point the nose towards this.
Yeah.
And when we come back, you'll see. It'd be pretty cool. See, do you ever think about doing that?
I do.
You point the nose towards this?
I have pointed the
mic. I don't remember.
I did. I interviewed a guy in Cape Cod, and we went to some place, I forget where it was.
I think I've seen all your riding shotgun with Charlie, and actually, I've seen a lot of your gun gram. I think most of them. Check this out right here.
That's pretty cool, man.
That's pretty wild, isn't it?
Damn.
This is pretty cool. Now, over there is where the lock is.
Can we get there from here? No, we can't get there, can we?
No, I don't. Is this a boat?
This is not a boat, and we're not jumping over like the Dukes of Hazzard.
Are you sure?
This is not the General Lee.
It's got a Hemi.
Yeah, I realize it's got a Hemi. That ain't the General
Lee. Listen, the whole ride you've been talking about this, it's got a Hemi, it's got a Hemi. Now all of a sudden you don't want to jump
it. All of a sudden it doesn't have a Hemi.
Now it's a 1974 Ford Pinto or something.
I don't see any gators.
They're here, believe me. Catch a lot of big bass right there.
Yeah.
A lot of big bass.
Cool. All right, listen. We're gonna hop out here. We're gonna get a picture of the three of us in front of this gator sign.
That's pretty cool. I like that idea. I'm game on that.
All right, Ron.
But when do you guys get out and take a picture of it?
Oh, no.
One guarantee though, you got to shake on it. I continue the drive.
You all right? I'll let you keep driving.
Shake.
Deal. Right.
Everyone's it. Shake.
All right, let's go get our picture.
Oh yeah, Charlie, by the way, don't molest the alligators. Leave that door open. long it took you to get in the car, Charlie? You had to wait for Kevin to get in.
Right.
Now, if you remember.
And I'm still clicking it before you.
Do you remember? Bam! Do you remember Cheryl Todd and Danny Todd?
Of course.
Down in Georgia. They were when they were at the NRA.
Yeah, in Tampa.
No.
Oh,
in Georgia.
In Georgia, yeah.
I think it was Atlanta, wasn't it?
Last year or 2 years ago, wasn't Atlanta?
I remember they rented. They rented a.
If you pull a Danny.
No. What does this have?
If you pull.
What? Dude, you notice something about this car?
Yeah, speed bumps ahead. That's what I noticed about this car.
No, look.
Oh, man.
It's an automatic, right? It's got sport mode. I won't do it to you.
We're back in drive.
No, I'm going to be nice to you.
All right. So we talked about Florida Carry. You did the open carry long gun stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Any what other events have you guys done?
We've done a lot of open carry fishing events. We've done where we just get together and have barbecues. We'll, of course, include all our events are educational. They're all family friendly. Everyone's invited to come out to every one of them. Florida Carry is a pretty good organization. We are growing by leaps
Watch
and bounds.
For the people.
I see the people.
All right. Watch out for the biker.
I see.
All right.
Why is the bike the bike's heading towards me?
Right.
Big white car. They're aiming for me.
He might be going faster.
Okay.
All right. So. You guys do some barbecues, do some open carry events, do some fishing events.
Yep.
All about education, all about the family stuff.
Yep.
What else do we need to know about Florida Carry? We'll put in links to.
I will tell you. There's big things coming.
Excellent.
There are some really, really big things. In the works for FC, and. I think it should be real. I think you guys are going to be excited. You're going to be coming down here. Oh, what was it? Next year's camping event. That's already in the works. Dates are planned, and we have some guest speakers that are really interested in attending. And
you've mentioned some of the names, and they are some pretty big hitters.
They are.
So very cool.
Who did we have this time?
This time we had Rob Morse from the Polite Society podcast from. Self-defense gun stories from the Slow Flack. I can't even say it again this time. Slow Facts blog. And we had Foster Coker. Oh my God, the story about Foster Coker was amazing. Like, it's why you should have a gun within reach and have one accessible and loaded and nearby.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
We have to find some place to. Let people know about Foster Coker story.
I will try to get something for you to put that up there. But if people want to, they can actually Google Foster Coker's name. Foster Coker, C-O-K-E-R, Jacksonville, Florida, home invasion, pretty much.
Mm. Home invasion is when someone breaks in your house and you're home.
I think you gotta be home for it.
Right. Well, rather than like a breaking and entering. Breaking and entering is when you're not home.
Yeah, I would think so.
Yeah, but you guys definitely need to check out. And if I get some links, I'll put it down there in the description. We also had Raquel.
Raquel.
She's got a lot of stuff going on. She's been doing a lot of great writing over the last few years. We also had a couple guys from Florida Carry. Whose name I can't pronounce.
We had Richard Nazcak
spoke.
We had
Jim Dykes.
We had Steve Moret, and we had our legal counsel Eric Friday was part of the Q&A.
Yes, he was part of the.
And
he
one of your.
He was mostly the A. He was mostly the answer. He had a lot of.
Yeah.
A lot of questions he answered, which was cool.
Yeah.
And the big headliner was none other than Masad Ayoub. Which was really cool. So I did a riding shotgun with Masad Ayoub. So if you have not seen that, you definitely need to check that out. I'm not sure what episode it's going to be, but you need to check out the riding shotgun with Masad Ayoub.
I think your shifter's broken.
Oh, I don't play these games, man.
If it moves over that way, right, it automatically goes into manual sport mode, which is pretty. I actually don't know what it does.
I don't know either.
Oh, we'll find out.
Woo!
We'll find out. It goes that way.
It goes that way.
Watch.
It doesn't sound good.
Look, it goes that way. It goes in the...
It doesn't sound good.
No, it goes right up. We're only doing 80. No, we're not. We're doing 45.
We're doing 79. Sorry.
We're back in regular mode. I don't want to burn your tires.
I am so glad I wore my brown pants.
Did you? Oh, check it out.
This
is where we're gonna drive into the lock right here and check out where the.
Oh, cool. Check out where the
gators are. The English lock here.
That's what you told me about the last place that there were gators there.
No, there are, but we didn't want to get out. Look, there's burnout marks over here.
Yeah.
They're pretty short.
Probably from the last episode you filmed.
No, I bet you I could beat those ones.
It's 15.
15, and there's people walking with a dog.
With a dog.
So we'll be super, super respectful and nice.
Gates locked promptly at sundown.
All right, it's not sundown. Look, you're about to see gators. Let's wave to the people. How you doing?
Hey.
Show we're nice and friendly.
Dude, looks like Crocodile Dundee.
How you doing? Was she skiing? I don't think so.
I think she needed that.
I think they were like,
this is where the boat
goes. Oh, this is a great place
starts?
For... No, this is the spillway here. This goes... Maybe I can show you. Just off to the right is the Gulf of Mexico.
The Gulf of Mexico is in Florida.
Is right over there. Only a couple miles down.
Oh, my gosh.
And this was supposed to cut... This direction was supposed to cut all the way into Atlantic.
Who decided to cut Florida in half?
I guess it was the Army Corps of Engineers.
Wow. Why would they
Now, usually they don't allow us in here, but... I say screw it.
Right. It's a Hemi.
They'll let us in.
You're not going over that bridge, are you?
No. We're gonna go over here. See if we don't get in trouble.
Great.
Let's try not. People are out.
Right.
I'm probably gonna get in trouble.
Probably.
But, wait. I'll just tell them I'm with a.
Tell them you're with Charlie.
I'm with Charlie. We're golden.
We're riding shotgun with Charlie.
We're golden.
All right. We can't see.
Hey. All right. You can't see anything yet, but we're gonna get out, take some pictures. But look, that's the lock.
That is the lock.
And it runs all the way out west that way to the Gulf of Mexico. And it goes into, was it Lake Rosu? Rosu, yeah, something like that. I can't pronounce it. You couldn't pronounce Dunellen, so.
I know, right?
I think it works out. Anything else?
Bad handwriting. No, man.
We're golden?
Good to go. Are we done?
I don't know.
Oh, let's head back and talk about your new venture.
Good plan. Let's do that.
Let's do it.
You want to drive?
I'll let you drive.
All right, I'll let you drive.
All right. Uno momento. Por favor. All right, we just checked out some gators.
That sun is wicked.
I was able to commandeer my own vehicle here.
Only because
you're a nice guy.
I let you.
Right. All right.
Well, first, you know you have an open invitation to any event we do, right?
I'm on.
I explained that, right?
You did explain that.
Okay.
Thank you, I appreciate that. Very cool, I will definitely have to make it back down.
This was
a lot of fun. This was great. I got to hang out with a lot of new Pro 2A people. I believe in my head is not big, and I do not have a big ego, but it was pretty cool. We were hanging out last night with somebody, and they said, "So what are you doing?" I'm like, "I interview people in the car. I'm running shotgun with Charlie." He's like, "That's you?" I'm like, "Yes, that's me." He's like, "I didn't know. Like I said in my speech." He's like, "I wasn't there." Oh, thanks, man. So,
well, you did really good. You did the national anthem.
Played the national anthem on the trumpet, which was cool. One of the guys caught it on video, so he did put that up. He put it up on YouTube already, which is cool.
Yeah, that was Mark.
Yes.
Mark's a good guy.
He had James Madison on the YouTube.
James Madison, yeah, as a First Amendment auditor.
Very cool. All right, so let's talk about, we got a little bit of time left. Let's talk about some other stuff that you do. You started a Facebook page. A few years ago. Tell us about that.
Talk about AUD, America Under Stress?
Yes.
Okay.
America Under Stress.
I started that in 2013, I believe, because I got kicked off of a couple of Facebook groups for just speaking my mind, and if they didn't like my opinion, and nothing bad, no curse words, no insults, no personal attacks, Well, they just didn't like my opinion, so they would boot me. So I thought, that's not really First Amendment friendly.
Not very constitutional friendly.
Even though Facebook's not really First Amendment friendly, I tried to...
Second Amendment friendly for that.
Or any amendment friendly. Mm. Except for, they definitely don't... They don't like any.
Right.
I don't think they like any. But we started that and got some great members in there and really incredible people that are extremely active on the America Under Distress group.
Very cool. How many people are members now?
I think we're just over like 700.
Wow.
700. No, it's not. I keep saying I don't care about the numbers. I care about the quality.
Sure.
And we're knocking that out of the park. That's pretty neat.
It is a team effort. Yeah, that's cool. That is way cool.
I've been asked.
And you have some big name people to contribute.
Big name people. We have Cheryl Todd from.
All right. Can I pass this guy?
Yes, you can pass. There you go.
Yeah, and I can because it's a Hemi.
You're around.
Hey, girl.
From Gun Freedom Radio.
Cheryl's awesome.
Yeah, we have Amanda Suffolk from Eye on the Target Radio.
Amanda Rock, she's my girl.
Amanda is awesome.
She's way cool.
I love her and Rob. They're really good people. Dave Workman is posting articles on there 3-4 times a day, and it's just,
wow.
I'm stoked.
I remember when you sent me a message when Dave accepted, and then you're like, oh my God, Dave Workman's posting stuff on AUD.
Oh yeah, that was
a big to do.
Jan Morgan.
Yes.
That's one that I'm like, this is insane. But Dan Wass.
Dan Wass too. He's awesome.
He's on there actively. But it's a constitutional page. It's not just the firearm, gun rights, Second Amendment related. It's everything. Mm-hmm. It doesn't matter if you were in Colorado and something's going on in your town that's wrong.
Yeah.
Tell us about it. That's
cool. Cool. All right, now you've also started something else recently. Tell us about that.
Well, this also goes from AUD. I've been asked countless times on starting doing a podcast, talking with Paul Lathrop from the Flight Slotty podcast, talking with Rob Orst, Dan, and Cheryl and Amanda, of course, and I can go on and on, but. I've been kind of saying, hey, you should do it. So my buddy Stephen Keith Jenkins, our Region 11 lead, one of the South Point 6 guys.
South Point 6, you need to check out their episode of Riding Shotgun with Charlie with them. And Mike Taylor.
Yep.
So we'll put a link to that. That one is probably not edited yet. But,
Probably not. And Mike Taylor's YouTube channel, Solo Yakker.
Solo Yakker.
Does a lot of fishing and two-way related stuff. But no, Stephen and I got together and we brainstormed for a while and we're about to start a video podcast called City Tavern Talk.
City Tavern Talk. Where did you get this idea for City Tavern?
City Tavern Talk, if you look back in Philadelphia, it's the City Tavern. It goes back to our founding fathers were gathering there.
Wow.
At this particular location.
Yeah.
And where...
Enjoy some libations and some liberty.
They enjoyed a lot of liberty.
Enjoy some libations and liberty.
I like that. But it's kind of where they went and they said everyone's on even ground. No one is above the other. Everyone speak freely and let's before the young. This is all before our founding.
The Constitution.
Yeah.
The Revolutionary War. That's a really cool idea. I like the historical aspect of it. That it's a place for people to go and gather, and everyone's even, and nobody's better than someone else, and everyone can speak their mind.
But unfortunately, I can't take credit for that that name.
Who thought of it?
Stephen Jenkins, are my partner in this, and my co-host. Can't take credit either. This was all his wife, Mary.
Really?
Mary, we were going back and forth talking, and Mary was right in there with us and helping us. And
that's cool.
We got green screens. We got a program we're using. We're getting ready. It's going to be unedited. We want
nice.
Just the flow and
unedited,
what happens.
Unscripted.
What happens, happens.
Very cool. I can't wait to check that out.
Yep, absolutely.
That's going to be a lot of fun.
I'm really excited.
Do you have an idea of when that's going to be up and running?
We planned 2 weeks ago to run our first episode, and Steven came down with the flu. So I didn't want to have to look for a co-host. So another co-host. So I figured let's
cool.
We'll wait. Plus I had the camping event stuff, so it worked out.
It's a lot. Yeah, that's a lot of work.
So basically, Steven's illness was for the good. I was pretty swamped with time and commitment on other things happening.
Event, right, always looking the bright side of life.
Absolutely,
that's cool. It's you know what? I mean, it's not that you're not doing it. Obviously, you just postponed it for health reasons, mm-hmm. and you had a lot of stuff going on. By the time this event comes around again, it'll be up and smooth and.
It'll be up.
Yeah,
oh yeah,
it'll be easy sailing, and then you'll be able to add all the stuff that you do for this event.
We may have a few episodes set up before the April 6th open carry walk.
That would be very cool. I'm going to get this episode out on the second Tuesday in March, so people will have plenty of time to share this with the with all the folks on AUD and on the City Tavern Talk Facebook pages, and get it out for a bunch of people.
I appreciate that.
Well,
that'll be really cool.
That's the least I can do.
I am really looking forward and seeing what the next adventure is going to entail with Florida Carry.
Yeah.
And the new responsibilities that will come with that.
Mm-hmm.
Psyched about that. I kind of like doing these events, Charlie. You know, I kind of like being behind the scenes type deal.
Right. I'm one of the guys. I like to be out in front. In front of people and whatever, it does whatever it does for me. But you think, and this is something we talked about, mm-hmm. you think that you don't contribute anything, but you contribute a lot. And people, in order for these things to happen, whether it's the open carry events or the fishing events or this camping event, somebody has to organize all this stuff, and it's a lot of stuff to organize. And I'm not a very organized person. This is something where you excel, and that's the way you contribute to, I hate to say to the cause, but you contribute
to the cause.
Yeah, to the cause, to the community, to the you know, because there are some people that have great ideas, and they're not great doers.
Yep.
And then there are people that are doers, but don't have any ideas on their own, mm-hmm. and you're the guy that organizes all this stuff and figures out how to get people, and I think that's pretty kick-ass.
Yeah, it's I appreciate that, of course, but yeah, it's like stuff that's out of my wheelhouse in a way, but at the same time, I feel like if I don't do it, who will?
Who will? Absolutely.
You know, I live by that motto, be that someone. So
yeah,
if I don't do it, who's gonna do it?
You got it, man. You got it.
We will see what happens here in the next few months, but
cool. Well, I think by the time I get this out, you'll probably have an episode of City Talk Tavern, and if you don't, it's going to be much closer to being out.
We're ready to put one out. We just have to find a little bit of time here and set it up.
Cool.
We still need to work out an intro what do you call it when it ends?
An outro.
An outro. Is that
intro and an outro.
Outro.
It's like belly buttons, an innie and an outie.
I have an innie. I think I've always had an innie.
I think you only get one. Either it's an innie or an outie.
Really?
It doesn't. Yeah. I don't think you can change your belly button.
All right. So if you had an owie. And if you had. That's good. If you had an.
If you had an outie, though.
I'd
look at it.
I don't know what to ask. We have any doctors out there?
No.
Our
doctors.
Belly button specialist.
Dr. Kevorkian is all we got.
Belly button specialist.
The belly button specialist. All right. Well, listen, Kevin, we need to wrap this up. We're almost where we need to be.
Yep.
Give us a rundown of all of the stuff that you have, the people you want to plug.
People I want to plug. Florida Carry, the America Under Stress Facebook page, Riding Shotgun with Charlie, Gun Grams. Of course, I on the Target Radio, big fan. Polite Society podcast, big fan, and look up to them. Cheryl Todd with
Gun Freedom Radio.
Love how she does that.
I can't
do it. Dan Wass's stuff with he's got so many things going
he's
on with his books
and the video. He cranks out some awesome.
What is the I'm at a loss of the words.
Good gun, bad guy.
Yeah,
one and two.
And then he, of course, all our speakers that were at the event. here, we had Raquel Oke, who does the...
In the Crosshairs?
In the Crosshairs.
She does Raquel Oke Reloaded.
Yep. Who else is doing shows? I'm trying to think.
Rob Morse.
Rob Morse. Oh, yeah.
Rob Morse. And, of course, we had Masada Yub. I hate telling
Legend.
People, yeah.
You were pretty stoked.
I was very stoked about that. I was way stoked. Way stoked. I'm not stoked about this guy that's driving in front of us.
Yeah, he's making it.
But they're turning, thank goodness. Yeah, this was a great event this weekend.
Over for you.
I hope so. This was a great event. We had a lot of fun. Got to meet a lot of great people, and it's all because you got this together and put it on for everybody.
Yep.
So, check out Kevin Sona and the America Under Distress. Check out the City Town Tavern. Check out all of the other people that we mentioned, because these are all pretty kick-ass people that we are friends with and are in our community that are out there making changes for everybody. I'm honored that you had me down here. You put me up. I can't thank you enough.
Thank you very much. Anytime. You're always welcome.
This is my pleasure. You need to check out all the stuff. I'm not going to list it again, but there's going to be links. Follow those. Check out all the stuff that Kevin Sona does. Also, check out the Self-Defense Radio Network, sdrn.us.com. It is all your pro-freedom podcasts in one place. We got KJ in the back.
The sequel.
The sequel. What do you like? Yeah, the sequel.
I love
the sequel, right.
That was pretty cool.
That was pretty cool. Anyway,
pretty cool.
So we got Kevin Jr. in the back. We got Kevin Sr. in the front.
Senior.
And we will talk to you guys next time on Riding Shotgun with Charlie.
Waiting for that.
I know, right? You're not going anywhere.
Cool, bro. I know I'm not. I'm going to make a look good at me. I know it's not.